you look in the mirror and see a tiny, barely visible black dot on your molar. It doesn't hurt. It doesn't bother you, so you decide to ignore it. You think, I'll deal with this later. But inside that microscopic dot, a catastrophic chain reaction has already begun. What starts as a minor biological flaw will eventually become a medical emergency. Today, we are going to simulate exactly what happens to your body if you never go to the dentist. We will watch, stage by stage, as a single tooth is eaten alive from the inside out. From the chemical destruction of enamel to the excruciating death of the nerve, and finally to the catastrophic infection of your jawbone. This is the complete timeline of tooth decay. Welcome to the anatomy of destruction. Before we see the hole, we need to understand the weapon. Your mouth is a battlefield. Right now, billions of bacteria are living on your teeth in a sticky colony called biofilm, or plaque. Among them is a specific enemy, Streptococcus mutans. This particular microbe is a master of survival, thriving in the acidic environment it creates. Every time you eat sugar or refined carbohydrates, you are feeding this enemy. But the bacteria don't just eat the sugar. They rapidly convert it through fermentation and release a corrosive byproduct, lactic acid. This is where the physics of decay begins. Human enamel is the hardest substance in your body, harder than bone. It is 96% mineral, composed of tightly packed hydroxyapatite crystals. But it has a critical weakness, acid. When the pH level in your mouth drops below 5.5, the so-called critical pH, the minerals that make up your enamel, calcium and phosphate, begin to dissolve. This microscopic leaching is called demineralization. Usually, your saliva fixes this. Saliva is your natural repair team and pH buffer. It washes away the acid and is rich in the very minerals needed to put things back. This process is called remineralization. But if you snack constantly, providing a continuous supply of fuel, or if you don't brush and allow plaque to mature, the acid attack never stops. The natural defense system is overwhelmed, and the fortress begins to crumble. This brings us to stage one, the white spot lesion. Most people miss this stage completely because there is no hole yet. There is no pain. There is only a pale, chalky white spot on the surface of the tooth. Under the microscope, the crystal structure of the enamel is becoming porous, like a sponge. It is losing density. The damage is still confined to the outer shell. Here is the critical truth. At this specific stage, the damage is reversible. This is your body's last chance to naturally heal itself. You can actually heal this cavity without a drill, but you need professional help. With improved hygiene, high concentration fluoride therapy, and dietary control, these lost minerals can be restored. The process of remineralization can seal the enamel, and the tooth can repair itself. But in our simulation, you ignore the white spot. You keep drinking soda, you keep skipping the evening brush, and the acid keeps drilling deeper. The acidic damage penetrates the deeper enamel layers, causing the entire outer structure to destabilize. The damage is now irreversible. Stage 2, enamel collapse. The porous structure finally gives way and a physical cavity forms. Now the bacteria have breached the castle walls. They enter the second layer of the tooth, the dentin. Dentin is very different from enamel. It is yellow, it is much softer, and biologically, it is alive. While enamel is like a shield, dentin is like a sponge filled with millions of microscopic tunnels called dentinal tubules. These tunnels run directly from the surface inward. This is why stage 2 is when you first feel pain. These tiny tubes lead directly to the nerve in the center of the tooth. This is explained by the hydrodynamic theory of pain. When you drink ice water or eat something sweet, the fluid inside these tubes moves rapidly. This hydraulic shockwave hits the nerve, causing that sharp, instant zap of sensitivity. At this point, the decay accelerates dramatically. Because dentin is softer, it provides less resistance. The bacteria spreads sideways and downward, undermining the strong enamel above. The tooth might look like it has a small hole on top, but underneath, the cavern of decay is huge, making the remaining structure fragile. To fix this now, the dentist must use a high-speed drill to completely remove all infected tissue. The procedure is complex, but relatively inexpensive. You need a filling now, but you decide to take a painkiller and wait. Stage 3, the infection of the pulp. The bacteria have burned through the dentin and reached the core, the pulp chamber. This is the heart of the tooth, containing blood vessels, connective tissue, and highly sensitive nerves. When bacteria touch the pulp, your body reacts with massive inflammation. This condition is called pulpitis. Anywhere else in your body, if you have an infection, your skin swells to make room for immune cells. But the tooth is a rigid, closed box. It cannot swell. Blood rushes to the area to fight the bacteria, increasing the pressure inside the tooth. But the pressure has nowhere to go. It compresses the nerve directly. This causes the most excruciating pain known to dentistry, a throbbing, constant pain that keeps you awake at night. This is often the point of no return. Pulpitis is classified as reversible if the damage is minor, or irreversible. Once the pressure is too high, the blood flow is constricted and the cells within the pulp chamber start to suffocate and die. The bacteria multiply rapidly and the nerve is slowly dying. The only treatment here is a root canal therapy. This complicated procedure physically removes all infected tissue and the dead nerve to relieve the pressure and save the physical shell of the tooth. The cost and complexity have now increased tenfold. But in our scenario, you keep ignoring it. Stage 4, necrosis. The pressure finally becomes too great and the nerve tissue dies. Suddenly, the pain stops. You might think, great, the tooth is better. You are wrong. The tooth isn't better. The tooth is dead. The blood supply has been cut off. Your tooth is now essentially a corpse rotting inside your mouth. This dead tissue provides a perfect defenseless feast for the millions of bacteria. They travel down the empty root canals, deeper into your head, seeking an exit. The tooth becomes a conduit for infection, pumping bacteria directly into your skeletal system. The decomposition continues silently, often for months, with the bacteria spreading laterally through the small pores at the tip of the tooth's root. This silent damage means that even if you finally seek help, the foundation of the tooth, the surrounding bone, is already compromised. Stage 5, the abscess. The bacteria exit through the tip of the root and invade the surrounding jawbone. Your body's final defense mechanism is to contain the infection by creating a hard, painful barrier of pus, an incredibly painful mixture of dead white blood cells and bacteria. This is an abscess. The pressure builds up again, but this time in your jaw. Your face swells visibly, you may develop a fever, the bone around the tooth begins to dissolve to make room for the pus. This constant bacterial attack leads to serious permanent bone loss, complicating all future treatments. This is no longer just a dental problem. It is a potentially fatal medical crisis. If the pressure from the abscess breaks through the bone, the infection can spread aggressively. If the infection enters your bloodstream, it can lead to sepsis, a life-threatening condition. In rare but serious cases, infections in the lower jaw can travel down to the neck, leading to Ludwig's angina, which can cut off your airway, or travel up towards the brain, causing massive complications. The tooth cannot be saved. It must be extracted. The timeline of destruction is complete. What started as a tiny, painless white spot has resulted in surgery, bone loss, and the permanent loss of a part of your body. Furthermore, the loss of this tooth will cause the adjacent teeth to shift, destabilizing your entire bite. The only long-term fix now requires complex bone grafting and an expensive dental implant. The lesson is simple. Decay does not sleep. It does not stop. It only moves forward. The cost of ignoring a cavity is always higher than fixing it early. If you enjoyed this deep dive into dental anatomy, you need to see how we fix this damage. Click here to watch our breakdown of root canals versus fillings, and subscribe to Dental Vision 3D for more science inside your smile.